talked about making it. I'm sorry that you never made it, and it pains me just to hear you have to say it. You knew the game and played it. It kills to know that you have been defeated. I see the wires pulling while you're breathing. You knew you had a reason. It killed you like diseases. I can hear it in your voice while you're speaking. You can't be treated. Mr. Know-it-all, but it's raining as fall. At least that's what his brain is telling all.
At least I helped me kill the president.
Thank you. Ah, Mr. Secretary.
Mr. Burr, sir.
And did you hear the news about good old General Mercer?
No.
You know Claremont Street?
Yeah.
They renamed it after him. The Mercer legacy is secure.
Sure.
And all he had to do was die.
Yeah, that's a lot less work.
We ought to give it a try. Now how you gonna get your debt plan through?
I guess I'm gonna finally have to listen to you.
Really?
Talk less. Smile more. Do whatever it takes to get my plan on the Congress floor.
Now Madison and Jefferson are merciless.
Well, hate the sin, love the sinner.
Hamilton.
I'm sorry, Burr, I gotta go.
But
decisions are happening over dinner.
Two Virginians and an immigrant walk into a room.
Diametrically opposed foes.
They emerge with a compromise, having opened doors that were
previously closed. Bros.
The immigrant emerges with unprecedented financial power, a system he can shape however he wants. The Virginians emerge with the nation's capital. And here's the pièce de résistance. No one else was in the room where it happened, the room where it happened, the room where it happened. No one else was in the room where it happened, the room where it happened, the room where it happened. No one really knows how the game is played, the art of the trade, how the sausage gets made. We just assume that it happens, but no one else is in the room where it happens.
Thomas Crane.
Alexander was on Washington's doorstep one day in distress and disarray.
Thomas Crane.
Alexander said,
I've nowhere else to turn.
And basically.